In this video, we're going to look at reflections about the x-axis and the y-axis and how we can recognize them given functions. So we'll start off with the graph of a function and its points. And let's take a look at what it would look like to reflect it across the x-axis. Notice what's happened. All the y-values have changed sign, but all the x-values are still the same. So the points that we have on that reflection are x, comma, negative f of x. So a function that's been reflected across the x-axis would have the form negative f of x, because it would have all the outputs that are exactly negative what f of x would have. Notice this is a change on the output, because we're making the output negative, and so we have a horizontal movement. It's being reflected across the x-axis. Now, we're going to use the same points, but a little bit different scale on the graph. Notice in this case, the sign was changed on all the x values, while all the y values stayed the same. And that's what a graph would look like if it were reflected across the y-axis. Again, we have our points. So the points for negative x, comma f of x would be the following. So in this case, our change is actually on the input. It's the x that's being made negative. So to recognize it in a function, we have y equals f of negative x. Notice now the change is on the input as opposed to the output, and thus we're changing the location of the output values as opposed to changing the output values.